I was always influenced by the times in which I live, and I'm sort of a watershed generation because I came of age just before the women's movement. And I grew up thinking that men were smarter than women, and nobody would ever want to pay attention to anything I ever had to say. And so science, well, first it appealed to my logical side, but also it gave me authority because it wasn't my ideas. I could really count on science. So science gave me some gravitas, and that's why I went toward it. Plus, I was attracted to it. And right after college, I worked in a deadly job in a lab, saw there was no future. So I did what most bright women of my generation did. We became teachers. And I couldn't get a job teaching in high school science, which is what I was certified for, but I finally landed a job teaching 7th, 8th, and 9th grade science. And if you can teach those kids with raging hormones, you can teach anybody. And it was interesting because that was the early 60s, and the book that I had to teach those kids from was dreadful. So I basically went to the library, found trade books that gave a more humane approach to science, and I basically made up my own teaching materials because there was nothing in the books that I felt I could give these kids. And then, of course, I got pregnant, which is what we did in those days, and I had to leave teaching because they wouldn't let me teach when I was showing. So I had to stop in my 6th month, and there was an ad in the New York Times for teachers to write educational materials, and I thought, well, if I could talk about science, I could write about it. And so that was the beginning of my career. And I've never looked back. I really have enjoyed mostly finding a way to tie scientific observation into the lives of children.